of designing, launching, and running a new business, which is often initially a small business. So you can define it as the capacity and willingness to develop, organize, and manage a business venture along with any of its risks to make a profit. The processes involved in entrepreneurship include developing a business plan, acquiring financial and material resources, hiring the human resources, providing leadership, and being responsible for both the venture success or failure. Today, we have many organizations that exist to support would-be entrepreneurs, such as business incubators, science parks, and chambers of commerce. Now, world over, there are different types of entrepreneurship: private ethnic entrepreneurship, institutional entrepreneurship, cultural entrepreneurship, feminist entrepreneurship, social entrepreneurship. We also have nascent entrepreneurship. That's entrepreneurs that are still in the process of establishing a business venture. Then we have project-based entrepreneurship, and finally, millennial entrepreneurship. That is using modern electronic gadgets and database to run business. That's where you get people like Bill Gates and Mark Zuckerberg. There are many factors that may dispose an entrepreneur to succeed in his venture. You talk about establishing strategies for his firm, including growth and survival strategies. Then maintaining the human resources in terms of training and recruiting. Then you have ensuring the availability of required raw materials. Then ensuring that your firm or business has one or more unique competitive advantage over others around or before it. In pharmacy, what are the various entrepreneurial opportunities available to us? I must say that in the field of pharmacy, we are very fortunate because every aspect of practice presents unique opportunities for entrepreneurship. Talk about the community pharmacy. Community pharmacist is an entrepreneur on his own. Takes all the decisions, puts all the factors together to make a gain. And I must at this point commend people like Ms. Julius Adelusi of Julie Pharmacy, talk of our brother Saiki Onyechi of Alpha Pharmacy, and Dr. John Boo Nwigu of JB Pharmaceutical. These are community pharmacies that are making it. Then in the media pharmacy, we have people like Ifeanyi Atuyi, who are all making it in the field of publishing and other news media aspect of pharmacy practice. Then for those of us in the academia, those in the hospital, we run consultancies, you know, that write proposals and do some research works for companies and individuals, and these things fetch us some money. So in pharmacy all around, we have opportunities for entrepreneurship. That is to say that entrepreneurship has a lot of benefits. Now, in pharmacy, we have the opportunity to hold our destiny in our own hands. Entrepreneurship gives us the unrestricted access to our time and the management of our time. It exposes us to unlimited possibilities and access to unrestricted resources. This is unlike what you see in the civil service, where you work under highly regimented conditions. Entrepreneurship is not like that. It gives you the freedom to experiment on novelties and innovations and offers you wings to fly to any destination you may desire to. That is why you can have entrepreneurs who are dealing with billions of naira or dollars, as the case may be. Just like on a lighter note, you can't have billionaire civil servants or billionaire lecturers, except if such a person is into siphoning funds or maybe has an entrepreneurial engagement outside this normal course of work. So the entrepreneur has opportunity to expand his business to any height he can think of and make all the money and resources that can be made. Beautiful and rewarding as entrepreneurship may be, it comes with a lot of demands, which I believe you have been learning all this while you are in the college. The topic for today is a very timely topic: improving your emotional intelligence for optimum performance in your workplace. It's very pertinent, it's very relevant at this time. Many businesses that started in grand styles with pomp and pageantry are today crumbling devastatingly because of lack of sustained emotional intelligence. I have no doubt that the resource person we have today will do a very good job out of that topic. So on this note, that I want to thank you very much and assure you that your enrollment into this college is an indication that you are carved out for, and indeed you are on your way to success. And I promise you that success shall surely smile your way, the sky being your only limit. Thank you very much for the opportunity to address you this afternoon. I remain Professor Emmanuel Chinedu Ibezin, FPSN, the National Chairman of Nigeria Association of Pharmacists in Academia. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you.